You remember at the beginning of this, when we said, yeah, we'll just do this little quest on the way to see Regis. Yeah, little quest. Yeah, right. Hi all, and we're back in Beauclair. Sort of wandered down from the forest. It's quite picturesque. We discovered a greenhouse, but I forgot to hit the record button. Anyhow, we want to get that black dye. So, we'll just see if the alchemist opens early. I'm kind of hoping he does. Thank you for saying so. Okay.
Welcome back, Master.
Good to be back. What do you have on offer?
Show me what you've got in stock.
Ooh, bit jerky there. Dye solution. We need 3. So we're buying 3. Right. Okay. That's it. That's all I need, I think, to make black dye. So let's just go to the dye armor. Need to make 1. Negredo, I'm sure we can make. Oh, white gold. Okay. One for good luck. Okay, Negredo. And then black armor dye. Okay, I think that's all of those.
Need to get going. Till next time.
Right, so let's check this out. In the inventory. Oh. Just as well, we didn't have to fight a monster then, eh? Okay, that's that back. Now, these have got a grey dye applied, so I'm guessing I need to remove that. There you go, back to green. Apply black. They kind of look like they did when they were grey. But okay. That's better. Yeah, I was kind of expecting the boots to turn black, and they didn't. And I think the reason they didn't is, well, because they were as they were. Tucson Knight's trousers. Oh, yeah, we're still carting this stuff around. We could do with dumping that back at the stash. But that means heading back to the ranch, which is kind of in the opposite direction of where we're going. Yeah, we're going to the cemetery to meet Regis, and of course our stash is that way. We'll just have to chance the fact that we don't find something incredibly useful and heavy. Is he talking to me about exquisite hair? Makes a difference from Velen. Why'd your hair go white? There are a lot of hooded woman characters inside Beauclair, which does beg the question. They're not all Bruxer or vampires of some description, are they? So I don't know if there's some sort of vampiric theme. Oh my god, look at this place. It's just stunning. Anyway, yes, as I was saying, I need to stop gushing over how pretty the place is. Yes, it's pretty, we get it. But I mean, it's painfully pretty. Are we going? We're going this way, apparently. Yeah, so we've got the spittle from the white. We need to check in on her, make sure she's okay as well. Hopefully she still is. Can I take a shortcut this way? A little bit? Yeah. There we go. Check in with Regis. Give him the spittle and then what were we doing again? So So we had, yeah, we did all that. Geralt found an old spotted white. So Geralt paid its cemetery hideout. After a long debate, two friends concluded the first order of business to find Detlaf. Yes. And we need the concoction to get Detlaf. So we'll do that, and then hopefully that should be enough for us to call on him. We can at least try talking to him. If that doesn't work, then unfortunately we'll have to fulfill our contract another way. Which kind of makes me think, maybe, just in case. Yes, it is stunningly pretty, but there we are. Oh, overturn cart, have we? Have we come across this before? That doesn't look suspicious, but the overturned cart here. Did we do something along here before? I think we maybe did, and I've just forgotten. Okay. Yeah, I think this was a good plan. The cemetery's a little less creepy during the day. Not much, I grant you, but it is a little less creepy. Is it? Did I just read? Lucas Shepokonansky died on his own blade while trying to show his knightly brethren his expert swordsmanship. They put that on his gravestone. We can probably read nearly all of these, and probably some funny ones. I might do that actually at some point. Right. Let's see what Regis has to say. As we tumble down the stairs. Where was he? I think he's... Oh, he's up there.
Think your friend's hand will make for a nice broth?
You've clearly honed your sense of humour. But we are not cannibals, Geralt. I took a fragment of tissue from the hand. It will suffice to prepare some resonance.
What did you do with the rest?
I cremated it, as our codex commands. A raven told me you'd acquired the necessary ingredient.
Spying on us, probably, but yeah. Helpful yeah.
Pretty helpful creatures. Calling them often.
I try not to overdo it, but they can be so useful, as they were now, when I merely needed to be sure I could arrive in time should things go sour.
Managed fine alone, but thanks for the thought. Gonna need much longer to finish brewing resonance. Mentioned a last ingredient, too. What about that?
We going off somewhere?
Might prove troublesome. You see, to use the concoction to summon the memories of one, the solution must contain the blood of another specimen of the same species.
Shouldn't be a problem. I happen to know a higher vampire who should be willing to help.
Yeah, go on, prick your finger, drop it in.
It's not that simple, I'm afraid. While you were away, I tried my damnedest to identify a replacement, but, alas, none such exists.
Not sure I understand what the problem is. Can't we just draw some of your blood?
The blood must be in an agitated state. As I'm certain you know, higher vampires can change their corporeal shell. As our flesh changes, so does our blood's chemical composition. To make a long story short, I shall need to induce in myself a state of strong psychokinetic arousal. In brief, madness, rabidity. And that stands to be very, very dangerous.
Oh, he's got to go full vampire then. The whole snarling and... Yeah.
Dangerous? Why? I mean, you'll still be you, right?
True. But I should be highly agitated, in a state of fury. You know better than I that fury cannot be controlled. If you've ever seen an enraged vampire, you know very well that all who find themselves nearby will be in grave danger.
How will we handle that? I'd rather not have you lunge at me, claws extended.
That makes two of us. But worry not. I've thought it through very thoroughly. Details to follow soon.
Okay, so how are we doing this?
All right, so what do you want to do?
We shall visit Teshamudna, an ancient vampire estate. There we will find cages suspended in the air. I will enter one, be confined. You will lure beasts there. Beasts you will then kill. The bloodletting should prove profuse. Abundant enough so that the blood scent will drive me mad. Wild.
Okay. Need to prepare. Maybe we... Should we? I think... I'm thinking, do I need to go and get all the armor buff and... have a night's sleep first? Maybe. I think we'll be okay.
Teshamudna, what's it like?
It is a place of torment, a torture chamber. Long ago, shortly after we'd arrived in this world, one among us named Kagmar developed such a taste and lust for human blood that in one night he could imbibe an entire village. This brought trouble on the entire species. Common folk wearied quickly of living in constant fear. They began to hunt us, seek the aid of mages and witches in tracking us down.
So what? Not like they could ever hope to kill you.
But they were bothersome. Forgive the comparison, but when did you last enjoy mosquitoes buzzing around your head? In any case, the other vampires decided something had to be done. Kagmar had to be caught and punished.
Okay.
A torture chamber was thus outfitted in the dungeons of Teshamudna. Inside it, a cage made entirely of a special alloy of silver, dalvinite, and meteorite steel. Kagmar was captured and locked in the cage. Sat there over 2 centuries, driven to fury time after time, never able to escape. Thus I know the cage will withstand the fury to which we shall drive my humble being.
Okay, then.
No reason to dawdle. Teshamudna, take me there.
In a moment. Just one last thing.
Don't die?
What was that?
Blood. Oh, the last favor the raven did me. I've also taken some sangurium, a solution that sharpens one's sense of smell. One drop of blood shall smell like a gallon to me now.
You crazy? You're a recovering addict.
Your outrage warms my heart, Geralt. But you must remain calm. I have no choice.
Oh dear. Is he?
This thing stand.
Gonna go kind of rabid on us?
High time we set off for Teshamudna. My head's spinning already, and you're starting to smell quite tasty.
And you're starting to scare me.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, Teshamudna. Mutna, rather. Big scary tower. Treasure chest? That's tempting. Showing us the treasure chest. Interesting.
We have arrived. The sacrificial chamber of torture and torment lies underground.
Are you sure about this?
Sure you know what you're doing?
I can only hope I do. Please, let's go. The longer we delay, the less control I shall have of my faculties. I'd really prefer not to hurt you.
Okay.
You lead.
Oh dear. That must be driving him slightly crazy as well. Human with blood everywhere.
Must be getting close to their feeding ground.
Correct. I told you there'd be danger. Beyond this wall lies...
an ancient vampire dungeon. Seen a lot of things in my time. Nothing quite like this, though.
My, I feel honored. A man with such a wealth of experience, yet I'm about to show him something new. Now, to open it.
Okay.
an ancient form of protection against unwanted guests. The mechanism...
Okay, if you don't mind. We're going to be doing that.
Only to a hive of vampire's blood.
Tricky mechanisms, a vampire hideout. Fortified, secured. Must have been important to your species once, Toussaint.
Mind if we light the way back, just in case we need to run out of here very, very quickly?
It shall always be so. During the conjunction, the gate from our realm to this one opened upon this land and no other. This was the first place we saw.
Okay. Oh, he's waiting for me, isn't he? Champion of Tessit. I am he who serves the tribe. Exalted above men, I renounce human weakness. Uplifted above men, I become keeper of my flock. Filled with strength, I turn my sword against the enemies of the tribe. I am master and slave. I am executioner of the will of the tribe. I accept this sword and this armor, so I may serve the tribe. Okay, loot all the things. Maybe we should have nipped back.
Human husbandry and care? This for real?
The author observed humans, their behavior, over the many years he spent breeding them. More than suspect though it may be, it's a thorough survey of the topic.
We are going to have to do some reading.
This place. There's evil here. Death hangs in the air.
Yes. Great many beings have breathed their last here.
Yeah, and it's slightly dark. I'm just wondering if we're going to need Cat or not. Another chest. Okay. What is that armor? It's all in black. That looks kind of cool. It's heavy armor. Tezza Munta steel sword. Killing opponents restores vitality. The amount of vitality restored equals 1% of the maximum vitality for each element of the set worn. Currently, that amount is set to zero. So it would only go to... What would you have? Assuming you had all the pieces. Yeah, anyway, back on track.
Glyphs are carved into the rock. Coated with blood used to be. They mean something?
They're emblems. Symbols of... well, what you would call tribes. Dispersed throughout the world after the conjunction. My ancestors placed them here to remind us all where we came from.
Cells? Who for?
Ah, disgraceful. Excruciatingly so, this particular page from my history. I'd rather not summon the demons of the past if it's all right with you.
And this one? Which tribe's this?
Garrosham. My tribe, and Deadlaugh's. We both remained in this part of the world.
Okay. Oh. It's very, very dark. I think it's time for Cat. Yes,
charming
I do.
Charming place. But what are all those cages for? Mentioned one vampire being kept here.
Yes, well, you see, humanitarians is something my ancestors were not. They concluded Kagmar would best be punished if he were tormented with the scent of blood he could not taste. Thus, they also kept humans here. Humans whose blood they slowly let. Kagmar ranted and raged in pain as those humans slowly bled to death.
They treated them like livestock, live bait.
I'd like to be able to turn back time, deny it, but alas, I can do neither. Feel shame for my brethren. That is all I can do.
Don't take it so hard. Nothing you can do about it.
Pretty grim. pretty grim. Awkward.
Fine. I prepared the bait. Please be so kind and place it. Ideally at the tunnel entrances. The scent will spread most effectively then.
Okay, it's as black as...
Place the bait at the tunnel entrances.
Pitch in here.
Monsters will...
I think, yeah.
Send more quickly.
That's a lot better.
These tunnels got here. Send shivers.
It was the natural order of things. The place reeked of death and it attracted necrophages.
We meant to... Uh-huh. And then there was... Place bait. Okay, another one there. Tunnels.
Three done, one left. Think this'll work?
I certainly hope so. The meat stench is so thick, I wager it carries clear to Novigrad.
Okay. Where are you? So it won't be vampires coming in, will it? It'll be whatever it is.
Bait set. What now?
I shall enter the cage. You must chain me inside. The bars are made of an alloy that will prevent me from transforming into mist.
Kinda thought you wouldn't want to.
I shall be in great pain. My sole thought being to stop that pain. I cannot know what I will do.
Okay, he's not quite as calm as he usually is, so... Yeah.
We must hurry. The beasts have caught the scent. Also, my head has started spinning.
Right, lock him in. How long does this...
That the blood?
...last, by the way? You know, him being agitated.
Does not know the true meaning of thirst.
Okay, what are we going to be fighting?
Maybe we need a safe word. You know, something you'll say when you do.
Sounds kind of necro-y to me. How's our sword? 91, and our armor. Just, it's time to do. It's time to do.
Take it anymore.
And what will you do once I utter it?
Calm you down.
Oh, God.
Somehow.
These were... Back up. Yeah, these are like, yeah.
You won't be able.
Mm-hmm. You just smell the blood.
Away. Oh, damn. No, what did I do? I stood in the middle of them as they blew up. That's what I did. You great big prat. Okay, deep breath. Concentrate and try not to die.
Bait set. What now? Maybe we need a safe word. You know, something you'll say when you can't take it anymore.
And what would you do once I uttered it?
Don't know. Calm you down. Somehow.
Please, go. You won't be able to. You must force through this, that is all.
Okay. Focus, 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 focus. Drop things. One, two, three. Oh, hello. Oh, God. Oh, no. I'm trying to throw a bomb. Wait, give me the vampire. Okay, any of them due to pop? Why have I Oh, it's... Go! Oh my god. How have I survived that? I don't know. Take Scuba, he's gonna blow. Just a vampire. Okay, Rock Fiend. Okay, is that enough? Okay, maybe. No, get out. Isn't one gonna blow? I thought one would blow. Let's go for... It says Rock Fiend. He should have exploded by now.
Come on,
they're not exploding. He should definitely have exploded by now. Okay, are these the last ones or...? He went, but he didn't kill the others. Oh, something else in here. Oh, good god.
Good.
Ghouls, okay. Can whirl on these. Okay. Those ones seem to be bugged. Ghoul, scurve it. Cool, okay. Get out of there. Whoa. Ghouls are okay. Scurvers blow up. Oh god, there's a vampire. Whoa. Okay, now they've got Geralt on the run. That's bad. One's gonna blow. I could hear him. Come on.
Hold on, I'll let you out.
Okay, there's still three freaked out ones. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh, God, that's some fight. Oh, kind of like. I'm going to be fighting him next. How do we sate his bloodlust? I mean, do we... I'm sorry, but that other claw looks like it would get him. Oh no, he's manacled. He's manacled.
A little longer. Blood'll dry in a few hours. Scent won't bother you.
Whoa, he's kind of scary when he's like that. Yes, he is. That was a hectic fight. Okay.
You can't finish it in this state. Tell me how. I'll help you.
How are you going to get him up the wall? Okay. Oh, we're right. Okay, we're back in the cemetery. I want to
Any
go
better?
Back to the place... There and
far from ideal.
Explore maybe?
And some time must pass before I fully recover. But yes, a bit better, thank you.
He might not want to talk about it, but I'm glad he sounds a bit more like himself again.
Never expected it to be like that. You didn't tell me.
We need not discuss it.
But we do. Because if I'd known you were going to subject yourself to torture...
What would you have done?
Found Detlaff some other way.
I did not wish you to use any other way. Did that occur to you?
No, because I thought no being would ever willingly subject itself to that kind of pain. You vampires aren't any different from us in that regard.
I told you, the pain is my way of paying my debt. The enormous debt I owe Detlaff. If I had to do it again, I would in a heartbeat.
I'm just glad he's not snarling and we're not stuck in a cage fight like that again. Although,
Residence, It's ready.
Are you certain you followed the formula? The proportions were exact, the brewing time precise. This is important, Geralt. The slightest deviation could cost even a Witcher dearly.
Relax. Got some experience brewing potions.
Very well. In that case, let's begin.
Okay. Is Geralt actually going to drink it? I was kind of hoping not to drink anything nasty in this episode. Okay, officially creeped out.
Excuse me, I shall only take a moment.
You jumped the queue, sir.
But Count, sir, you must understand, I've a meeting. The Count...
Sir, you were next. Please, take a seat. This gentleman was here first. Step down or you shall regret it.
Fails to realize he was your friend, Count.
Interesting. So, is this where he is right now, or...? Is this the guy's memory?
It was then I ordered him to give up his seat and step off the stand. If only you'd seen his face. We got him good, didn't we, Detlef?
Okay.
And then Mother insisted we buy the mill. Curious, eh?
Sure what to make of Detlef.
But at least I've a yarn to spin for friends and associates.
Forgive me.
What?
We still don't really know why he's doing this. Okay, so that's how the hand came to be there. And he's feeling remorse, I think. I mean, not like he shouldn't feel remorse, but I think he actually is. I think he liked the guy, but there was something else going on with killing him.
Awake at last. You ride like a squirrel caught in a snare. I'd begun to fear they were death throes, that you'd departed.
Sure wasn't pleasant, but it worked.
What did you see?
Delacroix. His death did not come easy. Seems Detlef had made friends with him.
Yeah.
Still killed him, and chopped up his corpse. And he was overcome with fury, remorse. Cut off the hand that had committed the murder.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And entirely unlike the Detlef I know. See anything else?
Yeah.
Saw a moment. Delacroix did something selfless, was kind to Detlef. Guess it could have been the start of their friendship.
Why the uncertainty?
Nothing extraordinary about it. Normal, everyday situation, really. Visions were supposed to issue from strong emotions.
Clearly the situation provoked such emotions in Detlef. Keep in mind, he did later murder Delacroix.
Killing someone who's grown dear to us, it's bound to elicit strong emotion. Vampires are no different in that regard. Did you see anything else?
Yeah, it did.
There was something. Showed up twice in the vision. A bootblack stand. Dedlau first met Delacroix there. Went back after the murder, actually.
Peculiar.
Stand was somewhere in the port district. And the bootblack acted as if he knew Dedlau.
That would be even odder. Perhaps we should have a chat with the lad. Though I would expect no breakthroughs.
It's our only lead. I'll go talk to him. Coming with.
I shall join you later if it's no trouble. I don't yet feel strong enough to venture out.
That's fair. Rest up. Be back as soon as I learn anything.
As long as we don't have to fight 20 bloody necrophages in one go. Oh, and we've still apparently got cat running. Which might be useful. I don't want to loot anything. Is he... Is it just up there he occupies, or is there a bit more? Take those. Well, we can read his books, though. Biography of the Vampire Regis. Oh, right. From the Quill of Dandelion. Expect many embellishments, then. One of the most extraordinary individuals I have encountered during my numerous adventures at Geralt's side, was the vampire known as Regis. To be precise, he was known as Emile Regis Regis. By his own reckoning, he was 428 years old and was the descendant of unfortunate beings trapped in our world during the conjunction of the spheres. You are surely thinking, dear reader, about Catacarns, Alps, and other such monsters, and are pondering how it was that a Witcher, whom, it must be admitted, is a slayer of monsters, came to keep such company. I must here explain that Regis was a higher vampire, a creature which physically does not differ all that much from a man. Higher vampires are also much more powerful than their wild confrères, and their regenerative abilities are significantly outpaced those of anything else you can have encountered or can even imagine. Yeah, I think he's outdone everyone coming back from being a smear. But it is not because of his outer appearances or inner strengths that Regis became our dear companion. True, he could be pretentious and rather pompous in his frequently length perrotations, but one would be hard-pressed to find in him the haughtiness usually present in higher beings. Regis valued human life dearly and refused to kill unless forced to do so. As he once confessed, higher vampires do not in fact drink blood at all in order to survive. They treat it somewhat as we treat alcohol. A rough grasp of this dynamic might be given to you by the fact that when we met him, Regis had been an absentee for years. He never revealed to us why he decided to join our search for Ciri. He had never met her before, nor did he live to see her. He died at Steeg Castle during the battle against the mad mage Villefortz, who was responsible for the whole affair. He died for a cause which surely he did not fully understand. But he did it to defend those he held dear, or simply because it was the right thing to do. I shall always remember him as a rural surgeon reeking of herbs. That is how he came to us during our first encounter at the Fencarn Necropolis, when we treated me and my companions to a fantastic brew he made from mandrake root. Wherever you are, my friend, bottoms up. Okay, so... Reddit. I sound like a frog. Okay, we should probably stop looting Regis's place. So, we have more to do. Find the bootblack who appeared in the vision. How do I get out of here? It looks so completely... Just out of curiosity. Yeah, that seemed far too inviting for it not to work. Oh, this is the cave we came down into, isn't it? Yeah, this that would kind of be the long way round, I think. Let's go back out the actual door this time. It just looks completely different now it's lit. Can we actually go back to that place? Because I'd like to do a bit of sniffing out around and looting. Plus, of course, the where, possibly, in this section, were books there about the upkeep of humans that I didn't read and probably should have read at the time. Oh, there we go. The most important aspect of raising human livestock is to provide the herd with conditions that, on one hand, guarantee their survival, but, on the other hand, do not extend too far beyond the minimum need for that survival. It should be borne in mind that creatures are bestowed with great intelligence, or rather cunning and instincts that allow them to gain as much as possible from their environment. In terms of husbandry, this means humans will always try to obtain more than we give them. It is recommended, therefore, to provide each individual with a place to sleep, a meal twice a day, and a permanent access to water. These conditions, which might seem overly luxurious to some, ensure the optimal production of high-quality hemoglobin. More details on diet in later chapters. Also essential is access to air, without which humans die within minutes. Yeah, that's been known to happen. There is no need to be concerned about the ability for human livestock to multiply in the conditions described above. If they are ensured a minimal existence, and male and females are mixed, they copulate irrespective of whether they are in captivity or not. It is not worth mentioning here that there is a school of thought that suggests treating human livestock with greater freedom and care, including providing them with better quality fodder and a certain degree of freedom. This allegedly ensures a greater amount of favorable elements in the blood and makes it tastier. However, it is worth mentioning that this method of husbandry is much more difficult and requires emotional bonding techniques, which we will be discussing in the following chapters. God. Transcript of a conversation between Master Ezeal Highgard and a human being. Okay, EH, who are you? My name is Alex Viscont. Why is all your skin trembling? I'm scared, sir. You're scared, I don't understand. You don't know what fear is, sir? No, I have mastered your language, yet some concepts are beyond me. What is fear? A feeling that destroys every other feeling. It controls your head and your heart. What do you mean? I thought it was a kind of pain. I have carried out tests in my laboratory on people and discovered that a mother subject to appropriate stimuli is able to forget about a child and think only about how to avoid pain. So fear would be similar to pain. No, pain rules the body. Fear is born in the heart. Oh, yes. What you say is very interesting. I think I will have to examine your heart in the laboratory. What do you mean, examine? I mean, take it out and subject it to proper examination. But sir, that would kill me. Yes, your mortality is a great inconvenience. But it was not me who created your species, and I am not responsible for its excessive frailty. The conversation was carried out in human language, in such it was written down. The transcription does not need translating. Whoa. Yeah, we read that. What was this one? Oh, yeah. Yeah. See, I know I've read these and they're all highlighted. And that one. Right, okay, so the old school vampires were utter. Yeah. It's 5 a.m. and my eyes are bleeding. I think we're gonna do white honey and a quick meditate. Nice. That's better, I guess. I might come back here off camera and, you know, read all these gravestones you can actually read down here, but I'll save that for another time. Okay, so find the blood boot black. Okay. Level 42. It proved quite the ordeal for Regis, a sacrifice one might say, but they obtained the last ingredient required for the for the resonance, and the vampire could prepare the concoction. Geralt drank a dose, and visions ensued. He saw Detlaf meet and speak with a young bootblack. Then the Witcher and the vampire set off in search of the boy. Did we? I don't know who did that. Okay, so where is this going to be at? Bootblack's probably in town, isn't he? Yeah, it would certainly seem so. We will definitely nip back to the ranch. In fact, I'm going to do that now. We're going to go back to the ranch and... Come on, magical horse. We'll see how Marlene is doing. Have a night's sleep, get all the boosts, faster, just in case this next section...
Come on now.
Kind of is that hard again, because I could have done with some extra potions or whatnot. But my god, that was some battle. It just felt really chaotically out of control for nearly the entire battle.
Ooh. All thumbs today.
Do I want to go this way or do I? No, we can. Don't need to go right through town, do we? Yeah, so we can get all our armour made up and everything else. Get patched up a bit, I think, after that. That was some fight. I would swear that that was more difficult than the boss fights at the end of the main game. It felt it, anyway. I don't know. Or maybe I was just a bit rusty. So there's a lot more darkness going on in the background here. We need to remember that what Regis can become. Even though it turns out he's a friend, it also occurs to me that he could very quickly turn into a deadly enemy. So yeah, we should bear that in mind, really. I was nowhere near you. Trotting through all nicely.
Not so fast, Roach.
Oh, I haven't heard that phrase in a little while. Out of the way, horse coming through. Orphanage, Beauclair. Not been there. I'm sure our adventures will probably take us there eventually, though. I didn't realise it was the orphanage. That's right outside Geralt's front gate, I think. This is our front gate, I'm sure of it. See how Marlene is doing. No, it's not our front gate. It's a gate, but I don't know if it's actually our gate.
My back aches, something horrid.
Good. Means you're working. Yeah, it is our gate. Just not used to having property. Alright, let's park you up, Roach. There's a good girl. You have a rest up there, Roach. Okay, so we'll see how Marlene's doing. And then we're going to have a big long sleep, get all our bonuses.
We could use one around here, full time.
Yeah, well, this is my place. You work for me, so Isn't that a happy coincidence? Marlene, how is she doing?
I do not know how I will ever repay your Witcher.
Don't expect to be paid.
I saved you for being Welsh.
That's all.
Oh, yes, I feel my strength returning thanks chiefly to Barnabas Basil's care.
Horrible ordeal you endured. Glad I cut it short.
Yes. Years of suffering. Do you know what was worse than the hunger? Watching my loved ones, my children grow old and die. All my family's long gone now. The last of my kin perished decades past. I fear I've nowhere to go.
Go to town, start a new life. You could... This is a big place, right? You could... You know, there's quarters. Maybe not as nice as your, you know, your villa or whatever was originally, but you're old. You know, what happened was a mistake. Stay here.
This is a big house, big estate. You can stay here.
Yeah.
I could never infringe so on your hospitality. Yet...
Yeah.
After all I've suffered, the years of starvation, I've but one dream. At last to prepare food that fortifies, nourishes, to delight in the tastes and smells of spices, to sit at one table with others and eat.
Don't see a problem if that's your dream. You could help Barnabas Basil in the kitchen. Eating his meals, you know he's not a culinary virtuoso.
Nothing could make me happier.
Hey, there you go.
Thank you
can...
No, thank you.
Work for me, be a chef.
Could use a woman's touch.
I've one other thing I'd like to tell you. Many years ago, my father assembled valuables for my diary. I never wet, so they remained unclaimed. These baubles are no use to me now, but to you, well... Perhaps let them be a token of my gratitude. If you wish to find them, you must go to my old home, to Trastamara. The dowry lies hidden in a barrel in the cellar. There are several barrels. You must give each a knock until you find the right one.
Do just that. Thanks. You sure you don't feel lonely out here?
I cannot say yet. Too little time has passed since you freed me of my thrall. But somehow, for now at least, I do not feel drawn to the city, to others.
Visited others' homes as a wight?
Yes, but ever at night, when all were asleep, I went in search of spoons.
Remember, you can always change your mind. Decide you've lived here long enough, just say the word.
I'd never wish to seem ungrateful.
And I'd never want you to stay against your will.
Anyway, are you a good cook? Can you do nourishing, like, you know, meat and two veg? You know, something like that?
I'd never expect someone with your past to feel drawn to the kitchen.
Do you fear I will cook in your home as I brewed as a wight?
Counting on you having slightly better taste as a human.
Of that, you can be sure. I loved cooking, even as a child. My gran was a true master in the kitchen. Her spit-roasted ox was famed throughout the land.
Thought you were a lady, owned an estate.
Do you mean to say a woman of my rank should have had a cook? You're right, of course. And I had the best of cooks. But I devised the dishes myself. They only prepared them.
Okay. Well, yeah, stay as long as you want and cook for Geralt and, all will be well.
See you later.
Take care, Witcher. And remember, you always have warm food awaiting your return.
Nice. Search for Marlin's dowry at the... God, my pronunciation's gone out of the window. Search for Marlene's dowry at the Transamata Estate. And while I'm thinking about going off and looking for dowries, can I get back to that place we went to? What was it called? Even. It was miles away, wasn't it? There it is. That's a Yeah, I'm glad we kind of teleported there almost. It's a long way, and there's something between it as well. But yeah. Oh, it's not actually that far, is it? And we've got to go there if we're going to pick that up. Yeah, night's sleep, and then we'll still decide what to do with ourselves in the morning. Yes, I know, it's still the morning now. We're having a very big sleep.